Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Little Miss Funeral YouTube channel. JoshyBoy500 left a comment on one of my videos, and he was asking if I could make a video explaining my first day in a funeral home, how it felt, and was I nervous. So that is what today's video is all about. Now, I want to start this video off by kind of explaining a little bit about how I got my first job in a funeral home. I know that I kind of talked about this a little bit before, but I always like explaining it. I graduated from mortuary school in December of 2010. I went to mortuary school at the New England Institute at Mount Ida College. It was located right outside of Boston, Massachusetts. But then after that, I came back to the Western New York area because that's where my family is. That's where I was born and raised. And I knew that that was where I was going to work and kind of just spend my life. So when I had come back to the Buffalo area, I did not have a job lined up. I kind of thought that I would have, but a couple of different things had happened, and the job that I thought that I was going to kind of walk into was no longer available for me, so I kind of came back to Western New York feeling a little bit discouraged. I had to have a job because I graduated from college and I knew I was going to be paying back my student loans and I was just going to have bills for life. So I started applying anywhere that I could, and it wasn't to like funeral homes. I was just trying to get a job. I ended up getting a job for a company called Alfred Angelo, which was a bridal salon. And it was kind of funny because when I'd be working at the bridal salon and you talk with the brides and different things like that, and I had one bride come up and ask me, you know, as we were trying on different dresses for her, "Oh, did you go to school?" And I was like, "Yeah, I just graduated from college." And I explained to her what I had gone to school for, and she goes, "How funny. You went to school for the saddest day of your life, but you are working for a job that is supposed to be the happiest day of somebody's life." And I thought that that was kind of a cool comment, and I always remembered that. So for 2 months, I was working at this bridal salon selling wedding dresses. The end of January, then, of 2011, I really started to actively look into funeral service again and trying to get a job in a funeral home because it was what I wanted to do. I didn't want my degree to go to waste. So I had a cousin who had a friend who was a friend of a funeral director, if you can kind of follow that. And she gave me his number, told me to give him a call, and I did. I basically wanted to call this funeral director to kind of start getting advice and find out the different steps that I had to take to become licensed in New York State. So I wasn't calling him looking for a job, but I was positive that our meeting could potentially lead to a job. So even though it wasn't a job interview, I was kind of treating it like it was one. He agreed to meet with me. I went to his funeral home, ended up talking with him, and he basically offered me a job right away. So that was something unexpected, but so positive that had happened in my life. When he offered me the job, I had to put in my 2 weeks at the bridal salon. So I did. We had a date set for me to start at the funeral home. And then basically it was just kind of finishing up my one job and transitioning into working for a funeral home. My first day of work, I remember I was wearing this gray suit. I arrived at 9 a.m. that morning, and with me, I don't know why, but I brought my makeup kit that I had in mortuary school when I took restorative art. Dodge actually sponsored like parts of my mortuary college, like the embalming and different things like that. So when you took restorative art at my mortuary school, they kind of gave you a bunch of like Dodge makeup for deceased. I don't know why, but I was like, I'm gonna bring my makeup kit, and I did. And I walked up, went to the funeral home, we went into the office, and I was like, I have everything that I need. Although, like, I was 20 years old. I don't know why I was thinking. Obviously this funeral home had their own mortuary makeup, but I just thought that I would bring bring my own. At this funeral firm, there was the owner of the funeral firm, an office secretary, a licensed funeral director, and then myself. And at this point, I was not a resident funeral director. I was basically just a funeral associate. The goal for me was to get my residency, do my residency at this funeral home, and then become licensed. But at this point, I legally could not do really anything other than like office work, file death certificates. I couldn't meet with a family or embalm or different things because I didn't have a license or a resident number. I go into the office and I meet the one funeral director who was not the owner, but he was the one who was kind of going to be training me. And I walk in and I remember walking up the steps because I hadn't met him prior to this. I had only met the owner, and he was chewing gum and he was setting aside a bag for a visitation that a lot of funeral homes have, where they'll put the register book, the death certificates, thank you cards, prayer cards, they'll put stuff like that. He turned around and then I was like, oh, are you so and so? And he was like, oh, it's nice to meet you. He was so nice. That day was basically me just following him around like a little puppy. So whatever he did that day, I just shadowed him. And looking back, he, like, how annoying to kind of have just like a little girl following you around all day. He probably looked at me and thought like, oh, she's never gonna last. But he was great. He explained everything to me, everything that he was doing, everything that he had to do. And it was just a really positive first day because I had somebody there who really was able to take me under his wing and just, even if he didn't take me seriously, which I don't know if he did or didn't, but even if he didn't take me seriously, he never acted like he didn't. He always thoroughly explained things to me. I remember that day they were going to have a visitation starting, so we went down into one of the funeral chapels, and there was a woman who was being laid out in the casket. And he had to complete her makeup. And in my mind, I'm thinking like, oh, good thing I have my makeup kit upstairs. But once again, the funeral firm had their own. So he started doing her makeup and explaining things to me, why he was doing things. And it was kind of cool to take my school knowledge and see him using it in a real life scenario. I was very nervous when I walked into the funeral home that day. I just kind of was thinking to myself, oh my gosh, I finally got a job in a funeral home. This is what I've wanted for so long. I don't want to mess it up. But I think that that nervousness kind of changed into excitement then, just because that day was so different and so new to me. And I think that whenever you do something new, there's that excitement of this is different and I'm learning a new task. And that kind of then overtook my the nervousness or the fears that I may have been carrying inside of me. Everybody at this funeral home was so kind. The office manager, they really made me feel welcomed. And it was nice not to be looked down upon because I was so young, because I was 20 years old, or to be looked down upon because I was a female, not to be looked down upon because I wasn't licensed at this point. And everybody just took me so seriously. And that really boosted my confidence a lot. I have thankfully had a lot more positive experiences within the funeral industry than I have had negative ones. I mean, obviously in any career, you do have negative aspects to the job, and I've talked about a lot of those on this channel, like my depression, dealing with compassion fatigue and different things like that. But at the end of the day, I really love being a funeral director, and I'm very blessed because I have had so many opportunities in my career to get me to the point of where I am right now. And those opportunities came because I had funeral professionals who were willing to give me a chance to prove myself. So for anybody out there who is looking for a job within the funeral industry, do not lose hope, because I had a job that I thought was lined up right outside of college, and it ended up not working out. I got a job not in the funeral industry, but then I was able to get a job working within the funeral industry within a very short time frame. And you just never know what kind of opportunities are out there. You don't know what kind of relationships can grow into job opportunities. You just have to keep putting yourself out there. Keep showing yourself off, selling yourself, and letting people know that you're passionate about the funeral industry, you're passionate about joining this sort of a career, and you're willing to work hard and learn from other people and to grow to better serve other people within this field. If anybody has any suggestions for any videos that they would like to see me make in the future, you can always put them in the comments below. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button so you don't miss any other videos that I may put out in the future. And thank you all so much for watching. I will see you all next time.